Hello students, this is my second video in the series of grammar for IELTS. In the first video I touched about these parts of speech in a short poem. Here I am going to touch them again very briefly. A noun is a word used as the name of a person, place or thing. Examples: Ashoka was a great king. Ashoka and king both are nouns in this sentence. Fagwara is in Punjab. Fagwara and Punjab both are nouns. The rose smells sweet. Rose is a noun. The sun shines bright. Sun is a noun. The word thing includes all objects that we can see, hear, taste, touch or smell. Or something we can think of but cannot see, hear, taste, touch or smell. So I'll be touching on these types of nouns later in the next class. The word thing, as in the definition we are saying, a noun is a word used as the name of a person, place or thing. So thing can be anything, whether you can see, hear, taste, touch or smell it, or whether you just can think of that thing, but you cannot see, hear, taste, touch or smell it. Adjective is a word used to add meaning, something to the meaning of a noun. For example, he is a brave boy. Here, boy is the noun and brave is adding to the meaning of boy, something to this boy, and so it's adjective. There are 20 boys in the class. 20 is the adjective for boys. Then pronoun. A pronoun is a word used instead of a noun. Examples: Jimmy is absent because he is ill. We are not writing Jimmy is absent because Jimmy is ill. We don't have to use the word this noun every time. So we are replacing it with he here. So he is a pronoun. The books are where you left them. So them is used for the books here. So them is the pronoun. A verb is a word used to express an action or a state. Examples: the girl wrote a letter to her cousin. Wrote is an action. She actually wrote a letter. She did something, write a letter. So she wrote a letter to her cousin. And Kolkata is a big city. It's a state. You know, Kolkata ek bada sheher hai. So is the verb here. And in the iron and copper are useful metals. Or is the verb in this sentence. Adverb is a word used to add something to the meaning of a verb. This is normally what I said in the poem, but adverb is also used to add something to the meaning of an adjective or another adverb. So let's see the examples. He worked the sum quickly. So worked here is the verb, and quickly is the way he worked the sum. So quickly is the adverb. So adverb here in the first sentence is for the verb worked. This flower is very beautiful. So here, flower is the noun, beautiful is the adjective for the flower, and very beautiful, very is for this adjective. So it's adding something to this adjective. So very is the adverb used to add something to the meaning of this adjective. She pronounced the word quite correctly. Pronounced is the verb. So she pronounced, and then correctly is the adverb for this. And how correctly? Quite correctly. So quite is the adverb for this adverb. So adverb can be used to add something to the meaning of a verb or an adjective or another adverb. A preposition is a word used with a noun or a pronoun to show how the person or thing denoted by the noun or pronoun stands in relation to something else. There is a cow in the garden. So cow and garden. So cow is in the garden. So in is the preposition here. The girl is fond of music. Of is the preposition here. A fair little girl sat under a tree. So under is the preposition in this sentence. So next we come to the conjunction. A conjunction is a word used to join words or sentences. Example: Rama and Hari are cousins. Rama and Hari. Then 2 and 2 make 4. 2 and 2. And is the conjunction. I ran fast but missed the train. Here but is a conjunction. An interjection is a word which expresses some sudden feeling. Example: Hooray, we have won the game. Alas, she is dead. So this is all about the parts of speech. Now, something to add to this is some modern grammars include determiners among the parts of speech. Determiners are words like a, an, the, this, that, these, those, every, each, some, any, my, his, one, two, etc. These determine or limit the meaning of nouns that follow. So if we say a noun, that would mean one. A banana, that would mean one banana. An apple, one apple. So these determine the meaning of nouns. In this book, as in many traditional grammars, so I am following this Ren and Martin book. So in this book and many traditional grammar books, all determiners except a, an, and the are classed among adjectives. So a, an, and the are taken as articles. All other these determiners which are given here, they are classed among adjectives and they are not separately given as determiners. So as words are divided into different classes according to the work they do in sentences, it is clear that we cannot say to which part of speech a word belongs unless we see it in a sentence. So they arrived soon after. So here after is an adverb because it is for this verb arrived. They arrived after us. So after in this sentence is used as a preposition because it is relating, showing the relation between us and arrived. They arrived after we had left. Now they arrived, we had left. These are two phrases or sentences also complete, and then after is joining them. So here it is used as a conjunction. So one word after can be used as adverb, a preposition or conjunction according. So we cannot, if just we are given a word after and we have to tell which part of speech it belongs to, we will not be able to tell because we have to see it being used in a sentence to say, to tell how it is being used and in that context which part of speech it belongs to. Thank you very much for this class. I'll be coming up with the nouns in the next lesson.